My name is Zach, and you're watching another bite-sized build video. Today I'm going to show you how I built this intervalometer for my DSLR camera. An intervalometer is a device that connects to a camera and automatically clicks the shutter button at set intervals. This is useful for time-lapse photography when you need to take photos for several hours at exact intervals. You can buy these devices off the shelf, but I thought it would be more fun and cheaper just to make my own. This project uses a lot of similar design concepts from my Stranger Things message wall video, so I'm going to try to reuse my efforts from that project. I will start with an Arduino-compatible microcontroller. To send the shutter clicks to the camera, I need to use a 2.5mm TRS audio plug. To trigger a shutter click on the camera, I just need the Arduino to connect the tip and the sleeve of the TRS plug. This completes a circuit inside the camera and opens the shutter to take a photo. It's also possible to tell the camera to autofocus by connecting the ring to the sleeve, but I will be manually focusing my shots when I do the time lapse, so I don't need this function. I need to take this short length of cable and solder one end to the plug and the other end to the Arduino. The wire corresponding to the sleeve gets soldered to ground, and the wire corresponding to the tip gets soldered to digital pin 2. To connect these two wires using an Arduino, I just need to write a logic low signal to pin 2. When I want to disconnect the two wires, I just need to write a logic high signal on pin 2. I'm going to test this design by modifying the blink sketch on the Arduino to trigger a shutter click every second. I need to change the blink pin to pin 2, change the on time to 750 milliseconds, and the off time to 250 milliseconds. Remember, I just need the TRS tip to be grounded for a short duration in order to trigger a shutter click. Here's a quick demonstration of this test code. You can hear the camera shutter click about once every second. I want to be able to talk to the Arduino using a smartphone app, so I'm going to add an HC05 Bluetooth module and wire it up to the Arduino. This allows me to create an app that sets the number of photos I want for the time lapse as well as the interval between them on my smartphone. The Bluetooth module uses the UART protocol to talk to the Arduino. It's important to remember that the transmit pin of the first device gets connected to the receive pin on the other device. It's a common mistake to assume that both transmit pins get wired together and both receive pins get wired together. It might be helpful to think about it this way. Each device has an output line and an input line. You need to connect the output line of the first device to the input line of the second device. This allows data to flow between the two devices. For the Arduino code, I need to read the serial monitor for messages from the Bluetooth module. Each message received on the serial bus will be one of three actions: either setting the number of photos to take, setting the interval between the photos, or starting the time-lapse process. All other messages received on the serial bus should be ignored. I can test this code by sending messages to the Arduino from the serial monitor in the IDE. I feel pretty confident with how the electronics are working, so it's time to move on to writing the Android app. When I did the Stranger Things project, I used MIT App Inventor, but for this project, I'm going to use an Android app called RoboRemo. This app allows you to create custom remote control apps that communicate over Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and USB. I'll go ahead and create the appropriate buttons and text fields I need to make the intervalometer work. I want to be able to bring this intervalometer with me wherever I go, so I'm going to design an enclosure and print it out on my 3D printer. I'll open Fusion 360 and extrude this shape. Next, I'll split the body in half using this midplane. With the two halves created, I can use the shell tool to hollow out the body and finally cut some holes for the TRS cable and the USB connector. At this point, the enclosure is ready for printing. With the 3D print complete, now I can test fit all of the pieces inside the enclosure. When I make enclosures like this, I usually have to make several iterations with changes in between to get things to work right, but this first draft seems to fit perfectly, so I'm just going to move on. With the electronics soldered, the Android app done, and everything put inside the enclosure, it's time to test out this intervalometer.
I'll power it with a cell phone charger plugged into the USB connector on the Arduino board. When I open the app, I'll connect to the Bluetooth module and enter the number of photos I want to take, followed by the number of seconds between photos. Notice how the app does some helpful calculations for me. If I take 548 photos at 60-second intervals, it will take 32,880 seconds to complete this time lapse. If played back at 30 frames per second, those photos will result in a clip that will be 18.27 seconds long.
This kind of information should help me out when planning and setting up my shots. I plan to use this device to take time lapse videos at night of the stars in the sky. This type of photography requires exposure times between 10 and 30 seconds and are only possible using an intervalometer. I took this project with me a couple weeks ago when I went camping in the mountains of Arizona.
We camped in the mountains nowhere near any big cities, which was great. However, the night I took this time lapse, it was pretty much a full moon. The moon reflects enough light in these long exposures that it almost looks like the sun. Instead of trying to fight this, I just ran with it and made the moon the subject of my time lapse.
So I think that's about it for this video. I make a lot of cool project videos like this, so if you enjoy that sort of thing, please consider subscribing to this channel. If you haven't seen my last video where I make a shop vac auto switch for my tools, I'll put a card here that you can click on. I really appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. I'm Zach, and I hope to see you next time. But for this project, I'm going to use an Android app called Romo Rebo. Oh my gosh, Romo Rebo. App called Romo Re... Oh my gosh, I can't get this right. An app called Robo... gosh, what is it called? Robo Remo? Robo Remo. Robo Remo. Robo Remo. But for this project, I'm going to use an Android app called Robo Remo.